I don't care if you vote for a dog or a donkey.
That's right.
Biden and Harris don't obey God, they're going to hell with Trump.
That's right.
Pastor Gino Jennings, the founder and leader of the First Church of Our Lord Jesus Christ, is a prominent figure known for his bold and often controversial sermons that address a wide range of social, moral, and political issues. His critiques are rooted in his unwavering commitment to biblical teachings and his desire to call out what he perceives as moral and spiritual failings in society. Among the many public figures he has scrutinized, former President Donald Trump has been a particularly prominent target. Jennings' perspective on Trump is multifaceted, combining theological critique with social commentary to expose what he sees as a carefully staged political persona designed to manipulate public opinion.
I'm not a Democrat preacher or Republican preacher. I'm a holiness preacher here.
That's right.
Who have no hidden agenda,
no agenda
whatsoever.
Amen. Wonderful.
Word to God, I say like Jesus, I speak openly.
That's right.
In the center of God.
In the center of God.
You want to know how we stand on same-sex marriages? We'll tell you. Mm-hmm. You want to know how we stand on the Democratic Party? We'll tell you.
Yeah.
You want to know what we stand on relative to the Liberal Party? We'll tell you. Yeah. You want to know how we stand on the Republican Party? We'll tell you.
That's right.
And all of our stand is right here in this book.
That's right.
Right here. Right here, I said.
That's right.
Jennings' critique of Donald Trump can be understood in the broader context of his ministry, which emphasizes authenticity, integrity, and adherence to biblical principles. He often speaks out against hypocrisy, both within the church and in the political realm. And his sermons are filled with exhortations for believers to live according to the truths of the Bible. In the case of Trump, Jennings' primary concern appears to be the dissonance between Trump's public persona and his actual behavior, which Jennings argues is at odds with genuine Christian values. One of the key elements of Jennings' critique is the idea that much of Trump's public behavior and statements were staged to appeal to specific voter bases, particularly evangelical Christians. During his presidency, Trump made numerous gestures aimed at garnering support from religious conservatives, such as his outspoken opposition to abortion, his appointment of conservative judges, and his public displays of piety. Jennings, however, argues that these actions were more about political expediency than genuine faith. He points to instances where Trump's behavior starkly contradicted Christian teachings, such as his often divisive and inflammatory rhetoric, his personal moral failings, and his policies that Jennings believes were not in line with the compassion and justice central to Christianity.
That's the way the false prophets did when Donald Trump lost the election.
Yeah.
Every last one of those evangelical men and women said, "We got it wrong this time. God have never got his prophecy wrong."
No.
Never.
Never.
He said not one word.
That's right.
Has fallen to the ground.
So shall my words
be. So shall my words be.
That goeth forth out of my mouth.
That goeth forth out of my mouth.
It shall not return unto me void.
It shall not return unto me void.
But it shall accomplish.
What?
It shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it.
Jennings' sermons often delve into the theological implications of supporting a political leader like Trump. He challenges his congregation and listeners to consider whether their support for Trump is truly based on biblical values or if it is influenced by political and cultural biases. Jennings warns against the dangers of conflating political allegiance with religious faith, suggesting that doing so can lead to a compromised witness and a dilution of the gospel message. He emphasizes that true Christianity requires a commitment to the teachings of Jesus, which include loving one's neighbor, seeking justice for the oppressed, and living a life of personal integrity. In discussing Trump, Jennings also addresses the broader issue of how political figures manipulate religious sentiment to achieve their goals. He argues that this tactic is not new and has been used throughout history by leaders seeking to consolidate power. By aligning themselves with religious groups and adopting the language and symbols of faith, these leaders can gain a veneer of legitimacy and moral authority. Jennings urges his audience to be discerning and to look beyond the surface to the true character and actions of political leaders. He calls on Christians to hold their leaders accountable to the same standards of morality and integrity that they would expect from anyone else. Another significant aspect of Jennings' critique is his focus on the role of the church in politics. He believes that the church has a prophetic responsibility to speak truth to power and to hold political leaders accountable. This means not only calling out moral failings, but also advocating for policies that align with biblical principles of justice, compassion, and care for the vulnerable. Jennings is critical of church leaders who, in his view, have compromised their prophetic voice in exchange for political influence or favor. He argues that the church must remain independent and steadfast in its commitment to the gospel rather than becoming a tool for political agendas.
Men tried to, like when Trump was running for president against Biden, do you see the evangelical lunatics? How the spirit of error. John said, hereby know we the spirit of truth and the spirit of error. The spirit of error fell upon the whole evangelical organization.
Yes, it did.
Jennings' sermons on Trump often include specific examples of what he sees as staged or insincere actions. For instance, he has criticized Trump's photo op with a Bible in front of St. John's Church during the Black Lives Matter protests, suggesting that it was a calculated move to appeal to religious conservatives rather than a genuine act of faith. Jennings also points to Trump's shifting positions on issues like immigration and healthcare, arguing that these changes were driven by political expediency rather than a principled stance. By highlighting these examples, Jennings aims to demonstrate the importance of discernment and critical thinking among believers. In addition to his critique of Trump, Jennings addresses the broader implications of political idolatry. He warns that placing undue trust or loyalty in any political leader can lead to disillusionment and a weakened faith when that leader inevitably falls short. Jennings emphasizes that Christians should place their ultimate hope and trust in God rather than in human leaders who are fallible and subject to the corrupting influences of power. He encourages his audience to be active and engaged citizens, but to always prioritize their allegiance to God and the teachings of Jesus above any political ideology or party. Jennings' perspective on Trump also includes a critique of the broader political and media landscape. He argues that the media often plays a significant role in shaping public perception of political figures, sometimes amplifying staged events and manipulative tactics. Jennings calls for a more critical and discerning consumption of news and media, encouraging believers to seek out diverse sources of information and to question the narratives presented to them. He warns against the dangers of echo chambers and the ways in which they can reinforce biases and hinder genuine understanding. Throughout his sermons, Jennings emphasizes the importance of humility and repentance. He believes that all individuals, including political leaders, are in need of God's grace and forgiveness. Jennings calls on Trump, as well as other political figures, to demonstrate genuine humility and a willingness to repent for their wrongdoings. He argues that true leadership is marked by a commitment to righteousness, justice, and the well-being of others, rather than by self-aggrandizement or the pursuit of power. Jennings encourages his audience to pray for their leaders while also holding them accountable to the high standards of moral and ethical conduct. In conclusion, Pastor Gino Jennings' critique of Donald Trump is a multifaceted examination of what he perceives as the staged and insincere elements of Trump's political persona. Rooted in a commitment to biblical principles, Jennings' perspective challenges believers to prioritize their faith and integrity over political allegiance. He calls for discernment, accountability, and a prophetic voice within the church, urging Christians to remain steadfast in their commitment to the teachings of Jesus. Through his sermons, Jennings seeks to expose the manipulation of religious sentiment for political gain and to remind his audience of the true source of their hope and trust: God. Ultimately, Pastor Gino Jennings' perspective on Donald Trump serves as a reminder of the importance of integrity, discernment, and faithfulness in both personal and public life. His call to prioritize biblical teachings over political expediency challenges believers to remain true to their faith and to seek genuine transformation and renewal in their own lives and in the world around them. Through his bold and often controversial sermons, Jennings continues to inspire and challenge his audience to live out their faith with courage, conviction, and integrity.